All right, we saw earlier Charlene San Pedro wearing Elizabeth Haley and, of course, Alexa Ilacat in Ryan Ablaza Uzon. Everybody coming down the red carpet. The pace is picking up a little bit, would you say?
I think that's right.
We are nearing the crux of this red carpet affair.
Yeah, but before we go to Gretchen, who are we seeing on screen?
Oh, this is Miles Ocampo.
That's Miles.
Oh, wow. Definitely making a statement in her pantsuit again. And Kate and JC joining us. Big flowers as the terno sleeve. That is her interpretation.
We've seen creative interpretations of the terno, which is very interesting, like what Charlene's wearing right now. The rose-shaped shoulders. It's very out of the box.
Okay.
She is wearing Ushi Sato.
This is now Sue Ramirez.
Sue is wearing Ushi Sato.
One of my favorite people in the world. She stars now in a movie called Cuddle Weather,
yes,
which is part of the PPP 2019.
Okay, Miles Ocampo wearing Mark Ranci.
And right now, we would like to turn you over to Gretchen Hall.
We have here the very beautiful Miss Dawn Zulueta. Hello.
Hello, good evening, everyone.
So you recently celebrated your milestone birthday, and netizens are asking about your youthful glow. What's the secret?
My youthful glow? Just peace and positivity.
Peace and positivity amidst everything.
Of course, always.
So how did you prepare for tonight?
Well, I didn't get to prepare very well because I got the invitation a bit late. But thankfully, I had a lot of very good friends that were able to spruce things up. Thank you to, I had Pepito do my gown, and then I had Patrick Rosas do my makeup, and Patty Inojales do my hair. So, good.
ABS-CBN is actually celebrating 65 years this year. How has ABS-CBN taught you how to give back to others, to our kapamilya?
Well, what's wonderful with ABS-CBN is that they champion all these causes, especially the ones that Gina Lopez was able to do. I was able to take part in Bantay Bata for a while. And aside from that, they also have Bantay Kalikasan. It's great because of this network, they have a huge... they're able to really go wide, diba? And reach out to more people, helping in terms of yun nga sa kalikasan and then sa Bantay Bata also.
You spoke about Miss Gina. Did you get to have the chance to work with her in some of those projects?
As a matter of fact, I did, because she invited me to get on the board of Bantay Bata a few years ago, and we were able to do some projects, some fundraising projects together.
And what do you think is the best thing about being a kapamilya?
That we are all a family, really. It really feels like a family every time you're in any kind of event here in ABS-CBN. And even the bosses on top make you feel like you're part of the family.
And it's nice, definitely, to feel family. That's why later on, Miss Dawn will be sharing with me her beauty secrets. No, just kidding. Thank you so much, Miss Dawn. Enjoy the rest of the night. Back to you guys.
Fantastic. I just want to point out also the Philippine National Jewel, which is, of course, our pearl, also making a statement on the red carpet this evening, courtesy of Dawn Zulueta.
And here Sara Labati also wearing pearls.
Dawn, that's right.
Future Mr. and Miss Gutierrez. I just want to share, Richard Gutierrez is actually wearing another Joey Samson creation. And this is interesting because it's actually four barongs. Made into one.
Wow.
So one part of it, the story of his stylist David Milan said, was a past barong. So parang repurposed to make it into a new barong. And Sarah is wearing Marp Baumgartner, and the oversized sleeve is her interpretation of the butterfly sleeve. And they said, well, Liz Uy, her stylist said that parang ano to, future wedding vibes.
Road
to the wedding.
I love clothes with stories. I love clothes with stories. Okay, Jed Medela earlier was wearing a Ken Ladaga, while Eric Santos was wearing a Joey. Eric and Joey Samson actually are old friends. That's a reason
Joey
they're Jane Oineza.
Looking fantastic, might I add.
Marachua.
And one more Joey Samson for Richard and Sarah. Yeah, so Joey Samson actually made my second outfit for my wedding. And he's one of these designers that knows how to have structure and androgynous sensibilities in his design.
Right. I love Joey's collars. I used to go to him for my suits.
Yeah.
And yung una kong, there was a blue suit that he made for me, and it was, I still keep it to this very day.
Yeah.
So, kanina, I was telling you about...
Bella Padilla?
No, Clothes with Stories.
Ah, okay.
I love Clothes with Stories. This is by Jaggy Glarino, my barong.
I love Jaggy.
And with a tie-dye trend.
Tie-dye, and Aika Villanueva, and we collaborated on it. Eric Nicolas is in Nat, Manila.
Manilag.
Bianca, yes. Who are you wearing tonight? We never
I'm
get
wearing
to talk
Rajo
about
Laurel,
it.
But this it's a Rajo. Actually a archive Rajo Laurel. It's called The Loose, kasi homage to Arturo Luz.
Fantastic.
The national artist.
I'm going to pretend like I don't know what you're wearing, so I'm going to ask you these questions. Chard and Sarah, hi. Who are you wearing tonight?
Mon, you helped us decide our outfits tonight. I'll let Sarah go first.
You look amazing, Mon. I'm wearing Mark Baumgartner. I wanted something timeless, something elegant. The theme is Filipiniana, so I wanted to respect that and wear something that I would still appreciate in 5 to 10 years.
I think 20 years or even like 100 years with this. What about you, Chard?
I'm wearing Joey Samson, and he made this very detailed modern barong. It's actually 4 barongs in one, and one of the prints is actually my old barong, so we kind of have that sustainability aspect to it.
Now, I know, where's Zion and Kai? Are they in bed? This is a parents' night out?
Yes, definitely. They're sleeping upstairs, actually.
All right, guys, enjoy the rest of your night. I'll see you inside. All right, have fun. All right, Gretchen, I turn it over to you.
I am with someone who is sure to have a lot of fun tonight. We got AG from the East, Alex Gonzaga.
Hey, Gretchen, or should I say G?
G-ho. Oh, diba? Talagang classic Alex Gonzaga. Alex, first of all, I'd like to congratulate you for getting 4 million subscribers on YouTube. And you celebrated recently your second anniversary with a Thanksgiving and Giving Back vlog. So why did you think of that?
Kasi parang all this time, all my subscribers or my followers, they've always surprised me. Sila yung gagastos for me. So this time, I wanted to give back naman. Kasi, wait lang ha. Live ba to? Medyo nagka-something eh. Kasi parang this time, I wanted, kasi they always celebrate the milestones in my vlog. So right now, gusto ko, sila naman ang i-celebrate sa aking second anniversary.
Matanong ko lang, mag-vlog ka ba tonight?
Hindi, mag-e-enjoy ako tonight.
Break muna.
Memes, memories in my mind.
Ay, mahirap kaya mag-vlog. Diba? It takes a lot of work. And minsan parang kakaisip mo ng videohan, diba? Nakalimutan mo na mag-enjoy. And for tonight, that's your game plan. How does it feel to have 4 million subscribers on YouTube?
I feel pretty. Yun na. Wala nang masara. Syempre, I'm so happy and I am so... Hi! Janela!
Ayan, eto talaga. Miss Congeniality.
Oo, nagbati lang ako.
Alex, you're always G and on the go. How do you do it?
Oh, you know, I'm really, really excited because hashtag we're always G, just like you, because of my Oppo A9. Actually, ito yung pinaka magandang mangyayari ngayon sa ABS-CBN ball ko pag attend ko. I can capture everything with my camera kasi quad camera ito at the same time, sobrang daming memories. So, hindi ko na kailangan mag-isip pa kung anong kailangan ko i-delete. Picture lang ng picture and at the same time, it has bright screen. So, I'm really excited dahil first time makakasama ko ang Oppo A9 sa loob ng ABS-CBN ball.
Plus, that has night features. Yeah. So you can take photos inside the ballroom, even if it's dark. Plus, sabi mo nga, diba, when you're, you know, you want to have fun tonight. So you don't want to think too much about the photos. So that's perfect. Diba? Maraming salamat, AG from the East. And I just wanted to say hi to Ate Tony. Oh, diba? Back to the panel.
Oh my goodness, there is one of the women everyone has been waiting for. Alex Gonzaga earlier wearing Joe San Antonio, and now it's Bea Alonso wearing, I believe she is wearing, hold on, I have that.
Okay, while you're looking for that, Anton D was in M. Barreto. Okay, there.
Yes, Bea Alonso wearing June Escario, and the inspiration is parang Spanish señorita. Ganun ang datingan. With a balintawak sleeve.
This is part of the cast of Ang Probinsyano. And earlier, have we seen Coco Martin? Not yet, right? We will be seeing Coco in a while. And
earlier,
Darna
course,
should be flying in.
Earlier, Bella Padilla was wearing Patricia Santos. And earlier, behind Alex Gonzaga, were some girls that some people have been excited to see, like Kisses Delavine.
All right, guys, I'm here with one of the most beautiful stars of the evening, Miss Bea Alonzo. Bea, I looked at your IG earlier and it says one day at a time. How is Bea Alonzo today?
I am recovering. I'm actually great. I'm excited to see everyone inside the ballroom. Yeah.
Tell me about your outfit. There's this exaggerated sleeve. What was the inspiration behind it?
So this is designed by June Ascario, styled by Pam Quiñones. Okay. We wanted to make a modern rendition of the balintawak dress back in the 1900s. Yes. So wala lang, we wanted to showcase the Spanish influence in the Philippines.
I know all your fans are waiting for your next soap, and you are working with my brother, so I'm excited.
He's so nice. I love your brother.
How is that so far? How's the show going?
It's been great, but actually, parang ano pala, nagsistart pa lang kami sa shoot. So, it'll be aired siguro next year.
Okay.
Let's watch out for that.
We can't wait. And Bea, again, we'll see you inside.
Thank you so much.
We'll have fun tonight, all right? Yes. Single looks good on you. All right. Back to Tito Boy, Sarah, and Bianca.
Iba ka talaga, Mon.
Wow. Raymond Gutierrez in the house.
Raymond.
Bea.
Sino ang may sala? I'm with Bella Padilla. Bella, congratulations on Mea Culpa.
Thank you very much. And thank you, mga kapamilya, for watching.
You have a lot of projects lined up. My gosh, your schedule is intense. You have a reunion movie with JC and Paul Soriano, another movie, and the MMFF. So can you tell us all about that?
Okay, so I shot the movie with JC Santos. It's a reunion project. We finished shooting it in June, but it's airing next year under my favorite direct, Irene Villamor. And I shot also a movie with direct Paul Soriano, written by Lav Diaz. So that one's more experimental, mas pang festival. Yes. So, yon.
And Bella, tonight you look really like, wow, super easy. You said that you could really move in your outfit. Can you tell us about your inspiration for tonight?
I can. So this is made by Patricia Santos, and basically our idea was to mix all of me into the dress. So it feels British, but also very Filipiniana. So it's Victorian, but also Filipiniana.
Bella, thank you. Let's have a fun night tonight. Thank you so much. And back to the panel, Tito Boy, Bianca, and Sarah.
We're trying so hard to keep up with all of the incredible amazingness coming our way.
So everybody's arriving now.
Earlier, of course, Coco Martin in a barong by Suited Up. JC De Vera wearing Paul Cabral right now.
And the couple. Wow.
Sharing a kiss on the screen, of
That's
course.
That's right. Jake Cuenca and Kylie Versosa. Arcy Munoz and Michael Leyva.
Kylie is wearing Cari Santiago, and
Beautiful.
Their stylist Adrian Concepcion actually said this is Sinulog inspired. Yung mga pa-cutout daw niya.
Ganda.
Well, Jake
is wearing a Francis Libiran. Ganda, no? But you were saying kanina, it's also the way, you know, people walk the carpet, relate to each other. Ganda, oh? Wow.
Really stunning.
It almost looks like body paint. You know?
I'm sorry?
It almost looks like body paint.
Yeah,
Ganda.
How it hurts her.
Well,
she's got
right.
that body to show off. We have Gretchen Felito on standby with our next guest.
Thank you so much. Yes, I'm with Coco Martin. Coco, wow. More than 1,000 episodes of FPJ's Ang Probinsyano. Congratulations.
Thank you, Gretchen.
Ano pa bang mga abangan namin sa inyo? Dahil after TV Patrol ay tumataas din ang ratings namin dahil sa inyo. Thank you.
Marami pa, sobrang dami pa kasi napakahaba pa ng kwento, marami pa pupuntahan yung buhay ni Cardo, kaya dapat marami pang abangan ng mga Pilipino.
Ano ang pinaka-grateful si Cardo? This is the 65th year we're celebrating for ABS-CBN. Ngayong gabi, ano ang pinaka-excited ka? Ano ang nilulook forward mo? At bilang Coco Martin, what are you most grateful for?
Siyempre, unang-una, ito yung panahon para kahit paano makapag-relax. Kasi alam nyo naman yung trabaho namin almost everyday. Ito yung time para makapag-bonding kami ng mga kapwa-artista ko. At makita yung mga celebrity, lalong-lalo na yung mga matagal mo ng mga nakasama.
At ang pinaka-excited ako, totoo ba? May in-announce na ba? MMFF na ba?
Actually, may naka-announce na Magic 4, pero yung iba hindi pa eh. Tinatapos
hoping.
Mo. Okay, hoping. Sana makapasok. Kasi sobrang nililook forward talaga namin na ano. Siyempre, iba yung pagkasali ka sa Metro Manila Film Fest.
Coco, all the best. Thank you. And let's have fun tonight. Maraming salamat. Tita Boy, Bianca, and Sarah, back to you guys.
Thank you so much, Gretchen. The party continues here on the red carpet for the ABS-CBN Ball 2019. If you are following us online, please don't forget to use the hashtag and peruse all the wonderful looks happening here. ABS-CBN Ball 2019.
Aww. Wow, Bayani Agbayani. We have great actors, Joel Torre and Rio Loxin. We have Audrey Diaz.
Sorry, gusto lang din natin magbigay pugay earlier. Walk the red carpet. The Queen, Judy Ann Santos Agoncillo with Mr. Ryan Agoncillo.
Wearing?
Judy Ann wearing Yong Davalos.
Okay. It's hard to keep up with what's happening on
is,
screen.
Isn't it?
All right, that's Moira and Nyoy Volante. I'm sorry, they have
Moira fresh from her Braver concert in Araneta.
Congratulations.
Yesterday.
And Moira
super,
is in.
Super
I'm sorry.
Not Manila.
Not Manila. Okay. Galing, I mean, all the stars are here at the ABS-CBN Ball. There, that's Moira. Did okay, she so lose weight? She did, right? You were saying?
How this happens, really. So the ABS-CBN Ball, what happens is when the guests are invited, be they Kapamilya stars, okay. The executives, all of the friends and family of the network, they're invited to make a donation to Bantay Bata. And the proceeds of which are funneled into, yes, last year it was a children's village, rehabilitating and
right.
Reopening that. This year we're talking about education. So this is not only a celebration of all the beauty of the Philippines, it is really going into investing into our next generation and our youth, which is always a great cause for celebration.
And that's right, because I hosted last year's program, and really, many of our guests, stars and guests who are not from show business, contributed to the funds of Bantay Bata 163 that actually allowed us to reopen the children's village. So this year, what Sari is trying to say, we are now focusing on Bantay Bata 163's Bantay Edukasyon. You know what's going to happen? We will be having elementary, high school, and college scholars.
Scholarships.
Ganda, no?
Really fantastic.
Fantastic.
You know, the beauty of a program is when you see it through from beginning to end. So our rescued children provided a halfway house and now being provided scholarships so that they can really advance and forward and reach their full potential.
And investing on the future of these kids, right? Right now, we would like to bring you back to Gretchen Fulido.
Movie in Pista ng Pelikulang Pilipino. Hello, I am with the very beautiful and sultry Miss Arcy Munoz. Hi, Arcy.
Hi, Gretch. How are you?
Hey, can you tell us all about your outfit? I love the mga open. Bagay na bagay sa film mo na open.
I know, right? And this was really rushed. Anthony Ramirez did this in just one day. He
one
made
day.
This dress for, yeah, just one day.
Grabe, ang galing naman.
Super rushed. And then sabi niya, kasi... So, basta, may nangyari. And then, he was like, okay, I'll make you a dress. I'll make something for you. And it was super rushed. He made for a day.
Because you also have pamilya ko. Ang daming happenings. And the other day, we were just at Cine Sandaan. How do you feel to be part of this amazing event also and be part of the 100 years of Philippine cinema?
You know, just to get to be invited is a really great privilege for me. It's such an honor. And to see a lot of celebrities in there, you know, celebrating Philippine cinema is such a huge honor for me.
And lastly, RC, how is your heart?
My heart? It's open.
I love it. RC, I'll see you later. Thank you so much. You too. Okay, now let's go back to Gretchen Ho.
Thanks, Gretch. And we are with Emma from The Killer Bride, Janela Salvador. She has her well-deserved off day today because The Killer Bride has been doing really, really well. I believe you had your Thanksgiving dinner the other night. You know, how has it been working with The Killer Bride?
It's actually been great because we've been receiving an overwhelming amount of support from the people and we didn't really expect that. So we're really so thankful to everyone who watches The Killer Bride
Every is this a different role for you playing Emma?
Oh yeah, it's the most challenging role ever because like I play not just Emma but pag sinasa PN, I also play Camila. And basta parang ang daming layers ng character ko. So
keep up the good work. But you know, how has it been working with Joshua Garcia for The Killer Bride? This is your first time.
Yes.
Paired up as a love team, how has it been?
Oh, it's great. Josh was really easy to work with because he's such a good actor. So we just feed off of each other's emotions.
May future ba ang love team nyo?
Love team? Tignan natin. Sana.
Let's see with The Killer Bride, but it sure is doing well. Enjoy the rest of the night, Janela. Congratulations. Back to panel.
Screen is superstar Vice Ganda. Wow.
A round of applause for Vice Ganda.
Okay, Tito Boy, to add to the Paul Cabral list, it. Believe it or not, Vice is actually wearing Paul Cabral. And you might be able to tell us something about this because ang inspiration nito, according to stylist Liz Uy, is the Carnival Queen Days of Manila.
Wow, the Carnival yes. Queen days. They were, you know, the only thing I remember about Carnival Queen is because I was raised by Tita Kunching Suniko, the great grand aunt actually of Tessa Prieto Valdez. She was Carnival Queen of 1935. Yes, it has grandeur. I mean, would you like to say something, Kate? The crown, the Vice Ganda thing.
It's, you yeah, know, right.
Ganda.
Vice Ganda really did it best.
But takes a certain character to be able to, you know, to be
definitely.
Able to carry something like
it's
that.
It's grandeur, yeah. But it's also whimsy, which it is. Really lends a lightness to the red carpet that I love. And advice, of course.
I love that contradiction, yes. The whimsical element to it and the grandeur.
Yes, absolutely.
Wow,
yes,
Vice.
Of course, also on your screens earlier, beautiful in red. Angelica was wearing Young Designer Light Shine White. We saw Ryza Senon. I think she was wearing pants as well.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. In Jeff Blaya.
All right, guys, the red carpet is chaotic, but I managed to find Ann Curtis right here beside me.
Hello.
And you look amazing. So tell me about your look tonight.
So I'm wearing Mitch Dulce, and we decided to go for a classic but meets modern Filipiniana, but still not steering too far away from looking elegant.
I'm into the hat.
Thank you very much. Of course, it's a Mitch Dulce piece, so there has to be a hat. But we went for oversized sleeves.
I know you might hit someone with that. But I know that you're working on a project this December, of course, with Vice, who's right behind us.
Yes, we have an upcoming film. It's called M&M, The Mall, The Merrier.
Okay, we can't wait to see that.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Have fun inside.
Thank you.
I'll see you there. And now we have the one and the only Vice Ganda. Parang hindi ako kasha dito, Vice. Tell me about your, I have to say, like this is one of the best looks tonight.
Well, thank you.
Tell me about it.
My look is inspired by the Manila Carnival Queen of the 1930s. Okay. This is this was conceptualized by Liz Uy, and the dress was a collaboration of Nerick Beltran and Paul Cabral.
Shout out to Liz Uy. What are you looking forward to the most tonight?
The party, of course, and of course we will spend a moment to just celebrate Miss Gina Lopez.
I was asking Anne about your upcoming film, and I know your movies are always number one every Christmas time. So tell us a little bit something about this movie with Anne.
This movie is going to be different from the previous movies I did. It's going to be like a comedy adventure film, and maraming fashion battle between me and Anne.
Wow, that is something to look forward to. Thank you so much, Vice. My outfit changed ba?
Yes, of course. Hindi ako makakaupo ng ganito yung damit ko, kaya I need to change.
All right, we'll see you inside, Vice. Have fun. Okay, ito na. All right, back to you, Tito Boy.
No, I just wanted to say, because I wasn't able to answer your question about the Carnival Queens. Pareho ito, ha? When they were doing the Carnival Queens, they were also doing this for a cause. And okay. Usually it was selected, the girl was selected by the boys' club. And very often, they came from very good families. So my Tita Kunching Suniko was Carnival Queen of 1935. That was a fabulous outfit, which was a collaboration between Paul and...
Nerick. Nerick Beltran.
Narek, that's right.
Sorry, they're
but styled by Liz,
to,
right?
Too cute to gap, but we have Jaden.
How can we stop with Jaden?
Okay? Oh my goodness. Nadine is wearing Michael Leyva. Again, a classic terno. Pero sparkles again. Kate and JC, everyone's in sparkles.
Can you take note this. Of the rainbow on James Reed's
yeah,
outfit?
Yeah, I love this.
Nice.
Wow.
See, James is wearing another favorite of the night, Paolo Lazaro. He seemed to have done a lot of the suits I was, for the
men rainbow. It's actually the colors of the Philippine flag.
Mm-hmm.
Let me correct
Lovely.
Myself.
Yes, it is.
And this is done by
Paolo Lazaro.
I was talking to him earlier and he said, I'm not going to make it early because I have a gig before the ball. So worth the wait, James and Nadine. We will have more, and the stars are starting to come in all at the same time. But we will be right back here at the ABS-CBN Ball Red Carpet.